What up, good people? Welcome to another episode of the 710 Slickville Show. I am your host, Jay Brown, a.k.a. Mr. 710. We back up in these streets one more again. I am joined by my co-stars on my right.
Hey, everyone, this is Sway.
I was like, is he talking about his TV right?
Cause maybe... No, like my real right. I only have one right.
I'm sorry. What's up, peeps?
Not the right that you looking at.
I'm sorry. In the building.
I knew that was going to happen.
And Erica Tiffany.
What's going on? How y'all doing today?
Doing amazing.
Look, I'm looking forward to this is about to be one of them shows. I'm going to go ahead and let y'all know that this is going to be one of those shows today. Our main topic is brought to you by. Yeah!
She was all in the DMs with this.
All in the DMs.
Small something that touched my nerves, but you know, we got several topics tonight.
Not what the main topic is. Hey, look. So look, y'all all know how we do this. This is an interactive show, so go ahead and like, share, comment. Make sure you call in today, because this is going to be one of those ones that we want to know what you're thinking on these topics. 470-251-4343. Who phone is still vibrating?
It's not mine this time. Normally it's me making the mistake,
because I am mildly lit, but don't worry about that.
Did you partake before you came on air?
I sure did.
Oh, that means you're going to really be clowning tonight, too.
I ain't planning on clowning. Anyway, I told you I was going to clown when you brought this topic that I had planned on crushing you.
And I asked you not to.
Don't worry about that. It's going to happen.
Erica, I'm a DJ.
Let me send you the life jacket.
I'm a DJ.
So, look. All right. So, on tonight's show, we will be doing since last week. We're going to talk about Jussie getting off. We also going to talk about, we're going to touch on Nipsey Hussle today. We're going to rest in peace. College admissions if we have time. But our main topic of the night is going to be why attractive people get treated so bad. Yeah!
So what did you do this weekend? We didn't do anything. We didn't do none of the normal stuff. How was your weekend, Erica?
It was phenomenal.
Good.
What's this last week? What's going on? What's happening in your life?
Well, my baby turned 1 month. Woo! Shout out to Joy Ashley.
Let me get this today.
No, you're not going to need that. Hey, look, so let me ask you this. At what point do women stop counting months and just use years?
I'm assuming when they turn 1.
No, because I mean,
people do 18 months and 24
some people,
months.
Walking around here saying 34 months. Like, whoa. I'd be confused myself. I had to get a calculator out. I'm like, man, these moms be serious.
I think after 2, you really, because they're the clothes. Look at the clothes. You got 18 months clothes, and you got 2 years old. It don't go 36, 42.
It just go 2, 3 after that.
They still do the most. Like, for real, moms be like, 19 and a half and 3 days and 4 hours, months.
What?
I'm like, what?
Those husky babies be wearing 18 month clothes, but they only be
6 months old.
6 months. Shout out to all those husky babies out there with the big cheeks that everybody la be grabbing. All right, are you gonna do that?
So what?
With your niece?
Do what with my niece?
Like when somebody asks, how old is she?
I'm with Erica. I think around 1. That's it.
So you're not
going
to be like 16
months? No, I'm not. Just, she's 1.
Just 9 months, then 1, 2, 3.
Nah, I've been a lost count on
the
months.
The thing is, people try to use that to gauge whether your baby is developmentally where they're supposed to be. Oh, she's
don't
16
judge
months
my baby.
She's not walking?
Don't judge my baby.
16 months, took her first steps. Started a little late. Carried her for a little while, longer than we probably should.
That's
have.
That's exactly what happens. They be parent shaming each other.
Really? That's what that is?
That's really a thing.
Are you serious? I didn't know that.
Girl, he's 9 months. He still ain't holding his head up.
You know
this
what?
This is a real thing.
Are you serious, Erica?
Oh, absolutely. It happens at, you know, out in public, at the park. Girl, look at that little baby over there. He still got a pamper on. Now, you know he too big. He got a sippy cup and a pamper.
Okay, I have heard those comments from people, but I didn't know that.
Women are ruthless. It's like it's a competition. Like it's a Olympic race to see who's the better parent.
That is so sad. I did not know
they'll
that.
They'll try to try you like, oh, how old is he?
Like,
because they trying to judge you on something. They trying to figure out how many months, weeks, whatever your baby
really?
Is.
Really? I'm glad you hit me today. When I have a baby, somebody asks me, I'm like, one. Mm-hmm. None of your business.
They get smart with you,
too. Where somebody shoot that club up?
Oh,
hey, look, I know a 9-year-old that still has a bottle.
A 9-year-old?
No. Nine?
You're making that up. You talking about your child? Your foster child? Mm-mm. No? You don't have a 9-year-old foster child. Mm. You're making that up, though, Jason.
I wonder if Julian Brown in the chat room knows if anybody
are you calling them
that's
out?
At least 9 years old that
are you calling
drinks from a bottle.
I wish you didn't drink tonight because you were too lit. I see it already.
What are you talking about? Listen, you have
you're
no
calling
idea.
Someone
you
out.
You have no idea the day that I've had today.
Okay, well, how was your day? How was it? Seriously.
No, we're going to go to
your I really want to know how your
week,
day was.
Since last week. Let's go.
Since last week, I went home, visited some friends, had a slamming baby shower. There was no baby shower games. There was no baby shower anything. It's decorated very nicely, but no baby shower antics. It was open bar and free food and a DJ in the corner, and we were lit. What happened? Yeah.
Julian Brown in the chat room said, at what age do you stop counting months? I get annoyed when the people say, my baby 51 months.
Exactly. Exactly. That's so annoying.
He said that too.
Then I have to go walk away and count so I can figure out how old that baby is. Don't make me have to do math when you tell me how old your baby is.
Okay.
Right. I'm like, wait a minute, girl, he's baby three. No, just stop it. One, two. After one, it's over with. But yeah.
Man. Listen, since last week.
Okay.
Number two, man.
You got to clarify because I have new people watching. So who's number two?
Number two is a 5-year-old. I have 3 foster kids. I have a 10-year-old, a 5-year-old, and a 1-year-old.
Right.
And so I call the 10-year-old number one since he came first. 5-year-old number two, since he came second, and the 3-year-old number three, which is the baby girl, which came third.
So number two.
Yes, she do. She drinks strawberry milk out of a bottle. That is a 9-year-old. He does know that.
Oh, wow.
Yes, that is a legit fact.
Oh, wow.
I was completely devastated when I first saw that. I was like, oh, wait, what are y'all doing? Y'all giving this girl a bottle? She is grown, almost.
Wow.
She can spell and count the 157. What are y'all doing? Okay. And so, look, this boy, I went to that company this weekend, and he has 0 boundaries. So, y'all come to my crib, he's going to lay on y'all. At some point, if you were in a situation in which he can lay on y'all, he will.
Just like this kind of lay on you?
Or
like,
no, I'm talking about get all the way on you.
Like on your lap?
In your lap.
At 5?
At okay. 5, he would get all the way on your lap. She was one of those people that happened to wanted to sit on the floor because that's her. She's a nanny as well. She decided to sit on the floor, and I was like, "Ooh, that seems like a bad idea to me because my dogs are gonna lick you in the face." And
number two is gonna sit on your lap.
Number two is gonna make himself comfortable. Now this dude decides that I'm gonna make myself 100% comfortable. And I'm going to play in her hair on the Derrick J side of the game. He was all up in there trying to braid her stuff. And
okay.
Like, there's only so much that y'all going to deal with playing.
I mean, physical touch is his love language, obviously.
Oh, my gosh. But then he was like, I'm not going to say her name, but am I cute? Is what he
asked. Oh, the 5-year-old ex?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Am I cute? And I was like, no.
Jason.
What? He's a boy. No, he's not cute.
He can be cute and be a boy.
No, how about handsome? Let's start the handsome. You think I'm handsome?
Okay.
Well, she says yes. Let me let you know that that answer changed immediately. As soon as he said, oh, it looks like you have a baby in there.
Oh, no. I'm assuming she did not have a baby in there.
She did not have a baby in there.
Oh, man.
And therefore, he is no longer cute at this moment.
No.
Like, I was like,
yo. You just told her she's fat.
Oh, you. You sleepy. Go upstairs. Go upstairs. Like, give her a break. Give her a break right now. You can no longer be down here at all. At all. Go upstairs.
So he's a little comfortable with adults.
Too comfortable. He also, today, he said also. Yeah. His new nickname is the Knockout King.
Okay. Yeah.
They're on spring break this week. And we pay for them to go to a date, to a camp.
Sure.
Pay for them to go to a camp. 10-year-old had a good time. Good day. 5-year-old, when I walk in to pick him up, he's standing off in the corner. He didn't see me when I walked in. I saw him. He was like, get away from me.
Ooh.
Leave me alone. To two little girls that walked past. And I was like, wow. All right, so what's going on here?
Mm-hmm.
The guy told me, he was like, yeah, man, he's had quite a day. He's been looking like that all day. Hey, number two, what's wrong with you? She don't like number two, though.
Just wish you could call him by his name. That's all.
I can't call him by his name.
Okay.
And so he's like, oh, now he's all quiet and whatnot. No. This ain't the time to be quiet. What's wrong with you? Dude was like, hey, man. He punched her and he slapped her and pushed her. I'm like, what? This is day one. Like, what's going on?
About to get kicked out of camp on day one.
Like, he said all the kids were kind of lit today, but...
He's extra.
You know, it was the first day, but he was different. And so I was just like, yo, man. I don't even want to hear your side. Go over there and apologize to them right now. Because there's no situation.
Where it's okay.
Because I know your life was not in danger in which you were needing to... hit this girl or push this girl.
Okay.
So tell me what's going on. Tell me what's going on. And his story was, I asked them to be my best friend. And they told me that they hated me. So I was like, so you decided to, that was your move? Now, they were cute little girls. But fam, if you want to be their friend, if you're trying to get in close to them, stealing on them is not the way. Like, you try again tomorrow, don't. Maybe they might feel different tomorrow after you brush your hair. But, yeah, he got the worst hair. He got that Kevin Durant. But try again tomorrow. But maybe a different approach. Don't start at best friend. Best friend is asking a lot. That's like, hey, I'm going to do special stuff for you. Like, I'm going to come get you if your car breaks down. That's best friend. Like, hey, if you don't have lunch, I'm going to give you half of my sandwich.
Yeah.
That's what best friends do. She's not going to give you half of her sandwich because she just met you in your hair nappy.
Oh, Jason.
Fam. But now, so you out here stealing on people. This is how you resolve. First off, you telling people to suck your thing when it's
I forgot he did.
When they too loud. And then over here, you're going to steal on people when they don't want to be your friend.
I forgot he did it.
Come on, fam.
We're working with him. He's got,
Figure it out.
He's a product of his previous environment. Good.
So is his brother, and his brother don't have those situations.
His brother's older. At 5 years old, he's still trying to figure out who he is. And being in foster care is tough and... You know, dealing with whatever situation he's come out of. So I'm sympathetic for number two.
Absolutely.
Look at you. Uncross your arms.
Right, you pound like you five.
I'm about to bring him to your house and let y'all deal with him. And then see how you feel if he asks you if you got a baby in there.
You said what? No, because I had somebody's son ask me that the other day. Because it's still like, there's still a little... thing right there. He's like, no, the baby's still in there.
Your mama's still in there.
But you still have the little, you know, so it's okay. It wasn't hurtful.
That's hurtful. I don't care nothing about that. I don't care nothing.
You'd be glad he didn't ask you if you had a baby in your stomach.
Right, because that really would.
Look, I asked this boy, listen, when I asked him, I was like, listen, you know the difference between good and bad. I know you do because you told me you do. And I was like, you know that you need to keep your hands to yourself. Because if you didn't, then you would try to hit me.
Right. Which
is
not going
to happen. If you didn't, you would try to hit my wife. But since you don't,
he's not gonna bite the hands that feed him.
I know that you know better. I know that you know better.
But we also know he has boundary issues. So he doesn't know when to love and when it's too much and when to hit and when to fight. He's learning that.
Yeah.
No, yeah, I'm gonna learn them all right. I'm gonna learn them all right. But look, all right, I don't want to talk about that boy no more. Hey, listen. So yesterday, after the guy came, he was finishing up the bathroom. He left. Next thing you know, I get a doorbell. Somebody rang my doorbell, and it was this girl at the door. Some random chick was at the house. I have no idea who it was or what she was looking for. She was just weird. Now, I guess she's probably about somewhere between 25 and 21. At that age, if you was going to somebody's house and somebody, like, I'm guessing that it was her first time based on the reactions. If you was going to somebody's house for the first time, but you knew who you were going to see, but somebody answered the door that you weren't expecting, would you have some kind of apprehension?
Yeah.
Like, even if you was going to see your girlfriend or whatever, like...
Mm-hmm. You'd be like, is such and such here, or am I at the right house? You just want to make sure.
Listen,
She want to walk in your house?
She's about to. She's about to. I open the door, and I'm in my lounging clothes, but I'm like, yo, like, when she rang the doorbell, the dogs went crazy. Mm-hmm. So you got three dogs going crazy at this storm door, like, yo, I'm standing there like, yo, so what you, can I help you? And she looking at me like, nigga, ain't you gonna open the door? I don't know you, you don't know me. I open the door, it's about to be a problem. Now, we have people that come to the house that are new.
Sure.
Strangers to me because of the social workers,
whatever.
And so, I don't know everybody, but I looked at her and said, I knew that she wasn't there for them because her hair wasn't done. Alright, what am I supposed to do?
Okay.
I'm
supposed to make, I make decisions. So I'm like, listen, I'm going to put the dogs up. I'll put the dogs up, push the door closed. And I open the door again. She's still there.
So did you find out what she was there for?
What do you want? What can we do for you? I think I got the wrong address.
Maybe she's an Uber delivery food driver or something.
She ain't had nothing in her hand.
Well, I don't know. Did you ever ask her who she was looking for? No.
I couldn't hear her over the dogs. And then when I went back, she bounced. So I'm just like, listen. Look, Eric said a mobile stripper. She's a bill for it.
Oh, maybe. Gosh.
But, this ain't what you want. Because the dogs is ready. I wouldn't have put my hands on her, but Harley would have made that thing happen. I would have made that thing happen. So, for everybody that just heard about Nipsey Russell, and it's all these conspiracy theories, Nipsey Hussle, my bad.
Thank you.
All these conspiracy theories going around. You okay? You seem to be sad.
I was sad. I still am sad about his untimely passing.
It is sad that,
you don't have to know someone to be saddened by their passing.
No, it's 33 years old.
33 years old, a father, old, doing meant a lot to his community, to the culture. Yeah, it's very sad.
There's a lot of people out there acting crazy.
Who?
Them California people.
I'm crip walking underneath.
I know. I knew exactly what you were doing. Jeez.
Can't let it go, huh?
Gosh.
Well, you see what she did. That's probably what she did. No. She make a sale.
Spell my name, my foot.
Another Audi out the door.
No. In California, though, it was crazy. Like, you literally could not wear red or blue to school, ever. No bandanas. No, like, it was serious. During that time, I mean, that was the 90s. But it was tough. That's how bad it had gotten at one point. Where teachers were just like, you just can't wear it.
Okay, and so, I mean, you've heard about the National Guard being there and everything like that, or not National Guard, but like them doing military drills in, like, in and out of businesses and stuff like that randomly. Like, Tariq Nasheed was on there talking about, like, them doing drills and stuff like that, and, you know, some of it might have had something to do with the... with the Dr. Sebi documentary. And
yeah.
His documentary and everything like that. And, you know, it's a lot of that stuff, it's interesting now. It's interesting now that you, right. you go back and you hear about it and you look at some of the stuff that he's done. And, you know, and I actually took some time and watched some of the interviews that he had. And I was just like, that is interesting that, yeah, this man stood before those folks and beat that trial. And didn't nobody even really... You heard about it, but you didn't. Mm-hmm. Like, there wasn't a whole lot of hoopla about it, and not a lot of people said anything about it. But it was like, who all are you actually taking on when you go ahead and say, exposed. Hey, mm-hmm. I can cure this, 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 and this. I can cure AIDS, lupus, diabetes, blindness. And they take you in, and you beat it. I cured 13 people of AIDS. Like, what? Shoot. Yeah, that's a problem. You are officially a problem.
Yeah, absolutely, because you're messing up the money that's coming in.
And then, like Chad said, he proved it. He proved it. And so, like, go ahead.
So do you think it's a conspiracy theory? What do you... Or have enough haven't came out yet for you to... kind of draw your own conclusion.
It's still fresh.
Very fresh.
I can't say whether or not.
Right.
I mean, it's going to be more and more things that come out.
Sure,
it's
going to
be a lot of people that got a lot to say about it. I listened to Brother Polite talk about it for a little while, and he was just devastated, just based on the standpoint, not even from a conspiracy standpoint. But just from the standpoint of, this is a young man that's out here doing good stuff, and not just doing good stuff from afar,
mm-hmm. right.
but he kept it in the community, and he was like, listen, I'm gonna show y'all how to do it, and you know, from people from where he came from, they didn't do that.
Right.
You know, it's like, listen, where can you be safe at?
Right.
Where can you be safe at if you can't be safe at home? You know, this is where, you know, when they talk about people making it and then going back to the community and making a difference in the community, and he was going back and buying real estate in the community, opening up stores in the community, giving jobs in the community, whatever. Like, those are things that did not take place, or, you know, most of the time didn't take place when you made it out of there. You made it out of there.
Yeah, you stayed out of there.
You was gone.
Right.
I'm like, no, I'm not. Are you serious? But right. then when you come back, and then somebody, I mean, you get taken out the game for whatever. Like, it's not like he was out there promoting crazy stuff. Like,
no, he wasn't. He didn't have beef with people in his neighborhood. He got along with people. He had, you know, people came out and had nothing but positive things to say about him. So... Off rip, you don't even think about it being some type of, you know, beef or gang related. Like, they can't say, you know, it looks like they won't have that angle to go, because, you know, so many people came out and said that, you know, he didn't have beef with people. He didn't.
Well, I thought that even if you had beef, there's like, if you that much into the streets, isn't there like rules to the code of how things are supposed to happen? Like, it ain't just, I got a problem with you, I'm about to go shoot you up in front of your store, in front of your house. Like,
right.
from what I don't know, obviously I'm not in that life, but, you know, that it's like, like, if your people got issues with their people, like, you gonna, there's going to be some things that happen prior to a shootout.
Right. Nothing happens.
When you're that.
A call man.
Right.
Right. There's some things like, hey, you need to handle this before we handle this. So, you know, it's just interesting to see how it all plays out. If this really is some street justice, if it is a conspiracy, you know, how deep does it really go?
Well, like, Mailman said, I believe your life catches up to you. I'm not buying the conspiracy in which. You know, there are things that happen. So, like, let's just say, dude that he slapped at the BET Awards. Mm. anytime somebody like that was caught on tape. So if somebody's like, you get slapped on tape, especially now.
Yeah,
you gotta retaliate.
As soon as that's posted, that's out there forever.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's I forgot he slapped that guy.
Everybody is trying to catch something on tape. Yeah. Like they had video of him trying to get resuscitated. What I mean, and that's out there on the net. Like
from already. What?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
And then like when you post certain things like my energy make me stronger and this and that. I'm not saying that's grounds to make something happen to you, but at the end of the day, like, it's not, I'm not going to post anything about anybody that doesn't like me. I don't care. They don't get that airtime. They don't get that energy. Mm-hmm. They just don't. I mean, if you don't like the show, okay. It's cool.
What about the young guy who's trying to take credit?
He a clown.
Right.
Who does that?
Even in comedy. Driving down the street on live. That was crazy.
Who does that?
Anybody could have did that.
Why, though? I mean, that's just...
Then he put his own life in jeopardy.
That's what I'm saying.
That's just stupid. Levels. It's so stupid on so many levels.
There's no... I put it to you like this. Ain't nobody in their right mind with the amount of people that revere this cat gonna be like, yeah, I did that with my face on camera.
Yeah. So he didn't do nothing.
Even if he didn't do it, clown. Just for fun?
He didn't clown. Do anything.
You don't think somebody can come for you?
Because if somebody run up on this cat, he was like, no, man, I'm just playing. I was just playing.
They're not going to hear none of that.
I don't think anybody's going to play with that, though.
Mm-mm. They're going to go ahead and take him out.
You don't play with that.
Exactly. You don't play with that. He's so dumb. He don't even realize he's playing with his own life.
But that's some clown stuff right there.
Right.
That's some clown
just to
stuff.
Sum it up, basically.
Like a lot of stuff that was being posted on social media in regards to this cat, I put it to you like this. Probably about 65% of the stuff that was posted about Nipsey Hussle today was probably just for likes. Probably just for likes. It's people that hadn't heard his music, people that didn't know what he stood for.
Right.
They saw Nipsey Hussle being posted and saw somebody get 1,000 likes. I'm gonna post it too. This clown ass dude, hell no. Hell no. Who out here outwardly confessing the murder of somebody?
Right.
I mean, you talked about Jesse. So he goes out and makes this fake claim, but you can go say that you killed somebody and it's okay? That's not
right.
Grounds for some type of investigation?
For them to come grab you up?
They would have been found dude.
That's easy to find dude.
They would have been found dude. They would have been found dude. This wouldn't even have been no story. He wouldn't even have been able to tell this, put this on Instagram. Mm-hmm. If he actually did.
I mean, I'm just telling you right now, if I went on live TV or I'm on live TV and I say I killed such and such, somebody's knocking on my door. If I'm just sitting here telling you
immediately,
somebody's probably waiting outside. Outside when we done.
Like, and there's all these people watching who can say she's on TV right now saying that she killed somebody, the body's in the truck.
Exactly.
I mean, I know today's April Fool's, but I mean,
oh, I can't. Like,
they're gonna meet you not, downstairs.
Yep.
You got 24 minutes left on air. They will meet you downstairs. It
might
matter.
Meet me up here.
Yeah.
I got the bag, girl. Time, yeah. To...
There we go.
They calling for you now, Erica.
I knew it.
710 of Slickville. What we got on the line?
What's going on?
What's up, man? What's going on? How you living?
I mean, not too much, man. I wanted to call in on that on the Nipsey thing, man.
Yeah. Mailman moment for everybody.
Oh, mailman.
What? Did somebody say something under their breath? I hear somebody saying something.
Hey, mailman, how are you?
I'm living. You all right?
I'm doing good tonight.
All right. How the panel doing, Erica? You all right?
I'm feeling fantastic.
All right. Okay. Well, look, this is what I wanted to say about it, man. I just believe that your life catches up to you. I mean, nobody really knows what he did when he was in the street cripping or whatever. And, you know, according to them, they saying he was still active as a crip. But nobody knows what he did back then, and nobody knows who still had beef with him and stuff like that. And at the same time, you on videos showing how much money you got, put money up to your ears, and You can't keep doing that to some people and somebody not going to come for you. It don't matter who you are. Somebody going to come for you if you send a splash of money, showing them what, how much you got. Because somebody out there broke and they want it.
But, I feel that. I mean, the thing is, like, I don't think it was even a robbery. Like, oh boy, just, it was a hit.
I think it was a hit, too.
Now, for whatever it was, or for whoever, like, paid for it or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, if it was, I'm pretty sure it wasn't no life-changing money. I don't care. If I did anything, if I was like, hey, I'm going to take out some trash for $50,000 or whatever, like, that ain't going to change my life. That's going to pay some bills for about 8 months.
If you're a young, you know, kid in the streets.
But if you ain't got no money out there,
right,
you do just about anything for some money. If you're sitting there broke, $50,000 is a lot of money.
These young folks out here will hit and kill somebody for, you know, a notch. You know, for recognition.
But I would just want to jump in on that because, like, people always say all this conspiracy and all this stuff, but, man, at the same time, life catches up with you. You know, whatever you did in your past, sometimes that stuff come back and haunt you.
Do you think they killed Dr. Sebi?
Huh?
You think they killed Dr. Sebi?
I don't know. I didn't really know about him. I read up on it a little while ago, and they were talking about he died of pneumonia in the custody of police.
That's interesting because
he died of pneumonia in the custody of police.
Yeah, he was in Honduras, and they said he was in the custody of like I said, this is what I read up on. I'm just like everybody else. All I'm doing is researching. But as I read up on it, they were saying that he was he died of pneumonia in the custody of the he was already in serving prison time. For something about money, or it was something like, I forgot exactly what it was. But anyway, he was serving prison time, and they said he died of pneumonia.
All right, man. Appreciate the call, man. I'm gonna touch on that just a little bit.
Okay.
Hey, man. Yeah, it's Mailman Moby.
All right, I'm gonna keep watching. I'll catch up with y'all a little bit.
All right, appreciate you, man. So one of the things that Nipsey Hussle said was that with him. Seeing what he said, being able to cure, you know, AIDS and all this stuff, and that there were, if somebody tried to sell something on your block, regardless of what it is, you know, especially like in the hood, you know, for $100,000, like yeah, you'll get somebody off the block, you get somebody on about the paint, you know, even if somebody tried to sell a little crack or weed on your block. You get him up out of there. Now, this is a $1 billion industry. And if this man tell you I can do it with some grass or some natural herbs or whatever, shoot. Part of that whole thing is to keep you needing medicine.
That's the bad thing about
pills, that they really don't help nothing.
So take them out and make it look like it's some street stuff.
Why not?
It's a possibility.
Why not? I mean, because it's easy to believe. I mean, that was the main thing. It's easy to believe. So let's go ahead and transition real quick.
So, I was riding to work. Friday morning. And, of course, listening to, you know, radio stations, different ones. I flip back and forth. I was listening to the radio station, and they made a comment, and they said it was a study. I don't know if it was actually a study done. I didn't bother to go and, you know, research it, but the topic was, you know, enough interest for me. So, basically, they were saying that from work to personal life, attractive people, men and women, and they said they did a survey of men and women, different ages, attractive people actually have it kind of rough from work to personal life. And they gave, you know, different people called in. A lot of people called in and touched in on, you know, just, you know, how things are at work between different, you know, between different women, different people at work, and some people called in. One guy called in, and he actually said that, you know, he would not want to date, you know, if you date an attractive woman, you do feel like it's a possibility she may cheat on you, she may be unfaithful. And this was a man who was saying this. And then, again, like I said, men and women called in. So it touched a nerve with me because afterwards I ended up recording some of it. And then I posted some of it to my Insta stories to get, you know, feedback. And then I shared about 4 pages of just some encounters that I've experienced in my adulthood. And I got tons of feedback in my DMs from just different people and a lot of people of just encouragement. And all the way down to one of my followers telling me about, you know, a situation that happened with her 4-year-old daughter. So it was just interesting when you kind of do reveal, you know, some of your insecurities or some of your fears or just some things you go through personally. Cause I'm not one to reveal all my personal stuff on social media. So it's interesting that when I did decide to, how many people just chimed in and had their own story or their own situation or just encouragement throughout the process. So one thing that's resonated with me was that I actually dated someone, and this happened to me twice in my adulthood, but I dated someone, and we dated for 3 years, and he wanted to get married, but he kept going back and forth. And then I'm a person of action. I don't do the back and forth. I'll just rather be out. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm not in that big of a hurry to get married. I'm not dying to get married. I'd rather be out because the back and forth is uncalled for. So by then I'm frustrated. I'm losing interest. I'm feeling a certain kind of way. And we broke up, and a year later when, he wanted to be friends and things of that nature. And I'm always, you know, down to be friends. I try not to hold grudges. I try not to walk in that lane. He told me that, you know, the reason he didn't want to marry me is because I got too popular with the Sway Sway modeling production company that I had. He said I got too popular and I was too attractive. And he felt as if I would cheat on him and I would make a fool of him in public one day. His exact words. And this guy was older. He was an older guy that I was dating. He was established and well off. His exact words that he was afraid that I would make a fool of him one day. That's why he broke my heart, basically. At work, I don't look nothing like this. I don't wear makeup. I don't wear heels. I don't do any of that. Because at work, just I've learned over the years, just, you know, different women treat you differently. The men, now when I have men bosses or men counterparts, work is a breeze. It's wonderful. It's easy breezy. It's just easy. They ain't worried about that. They just getting a job done, going on. But the women is just different. So I've learned to just kind of just play down and, you know, the makeup, the looks, I don't wear any of that. And I posted that in my Insta stories too Friday. I think you guys saw it, but I know a lot of my followers did. And I put no makeup. This is my look at work. Absolutely no makeup. I mean, not even mascara, nothing. Just bald, plain face and flats. Because just some of the things I have dealt with in women, you know, I wore, at one point in time, I wore, you know, pantyhose to work. They had one line going up the back of it. It was wintertime. I'll never forget, in Alabama, they called, you know, the little one line going up the back, you know, real cute. Had been wearing little pantyhose, little print pantyhose for at least a year when I had a male boss. When he got promoted, transferred, I transferred, and I became a manager somewhere else. They called on me, and then the memo came down, no printed pantyhose, no more. So I just feel that, you know, people say, well, you attractive, use what you got to get what you want and whoop de whoop and this and that. I disagree. When you are, I think, you know, the more attractive you are, I think you get it a little bit kind of rough. You kind of get, you know, you just kind of get shunned a little bit. And most of the time, you're not even paying attention to half of the stuff that's going on in the room. For me, for Sway, I'm not even paying attention to half of the things or half of the people that's going on in the room. I went home over the weekend, women in this event I was in, you know, clutching their husband's elbows. And I'm just like, back in the day, you used to speak to me, but now you got a husband and you think, you know, but I'm the single girl. Mm-hmm. See, I'm the single girl and I look halfway decent, you know, so and then I'm an issue. Then I'm a problem. But you used to speak to me back in the day when we all were single. But now you got a man and, you know, 50 more pounds up on you. And now I'm the enemy. But I'm the single woman, too, in this environment. So, yeah, I don't believe that, you know, fairly good looking people have it as easy as people think they do, because it's not the case. You know, and people always tell me, don't dim your light, you know, don't dim your light for other people. And it's just kind of a habit that I have now to just play it down. But, you know, eventually my personality will shine through and I can't keep it quiet no more. So, yeah, that touched a nerve. Like, it really made me emotional Friday morning before I went into work. It really did. I had to call one of my girls down, Sheridan the Leo. I had to call my girl Sheridan the Leo down in Florida because I just was like, I needed to talk to somebody. What up, Sheridan? She's in the chat room already.
What's up, Sheridan?
Someone said, you ain't lying. You're not the problem. The insecurities with their husband, significant others are.
And we know Sheridan your cousin. Go ahead.
Sheridan is not my cousin.
Well, it's funny. I was on WAOK over the weekend, and uh-huh. They brought this thing up because this was on V, was the station that they originally mm-hmm. talked about it on. I didn't actually hear the original broadcast, but it was brought up to me as a woman in the automotive industry. Do I agree or disagree with that? And unfortunately, I had to wholeheartedly disagree. And it's even hard just listening because I so strongly feel against it. I feel that, you know, being attractive is clearly an advantage in any situation to me. If people find you attractive, and obviously attractive is relative, but the idea of it's harder on me because I'm attractive or because is really a inner reflection outward of what you assume people feel about you, and then changing yourself to adjust to people seems to me is the exact opposite thing that you should be doing in those situations. And like they said, mm-hmm. you know, yeah, definitely not dimming your light, but God forbid I go into an office and try to look less attractive so other people can feel comfortable around me. You know, never in a million years would I think anything like that. I want to be attractive. I want to feel my most confident. Right. I want to stand out as much as I can because that's who I am. And if you have any problem feeling with that, that is more about who you are.
Absolutely.
Than who it is I am. And if you have an issue with your husband, all my friends are bad. Every Absolutely. Single one of my friends
Every
are
single one of my friends are. I right? can't. I'm sorry.
And so when I
You don't
want to
see us all together because then you really going to want to go saying, jump off
I'm,
the roof.
I'm not going to be like, well, I'd rather have unattractive friends because I don't want to worry about my man. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
My friends got hips, thighs.
Oh, they and got I it want all. All Every last one. I agree with you. So I agree with you.
If I have a problem, that's a problem with me and my dude.
Exactly. Something has happened in your marriage or in your relationship that has made you feel that way. And that happened long before I ever even came into picture. But are in the
neither
room.
Do with my attractive friends. Am I like, it's really tough on you to be so pretty. Like, I would, like, you get all them Instagram DMs. Oh my God, it's so
I hate
hard.
That. I hate that statement. Well, how many people are in your Instagram DMs? I hate that statement. I hate when I'm asked that statement. I hate that statement.
Just because the people that are not that attractive don't really have to answer that question.
I mean, ain't nobody in them DMs.
Now, I'm on the ugly side of the game. And so I'm gonna put it to you. No. I'm just gonna go.
Oh, you finna? Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm about to be that person right now. Oh, and so boy. Listen, all right. There's never been a situation where an ugly person, I mean, where a cute person has come to me and been like, "Yo, you know what? You sure be having to beat him off with a stick, don't you?" No, I'm ugly. Don't nobody holler at me like that. That's what it is. Now, where I do have advantages at is that. Pretty women might look at an ugly dude and be like, you know what? He's had to struggle all his life. He's probably good in bed.
Oh, God.
And, you know, those ugly dudes, them ugly dudes be having big things. They can't struggle all the way around. I'm just saying. So
I've never looked that up. No, I've never said that.
To me, it's surface level. And if people Very can't so. Get deeper to get to know you past the surface level,
absolutely.
Sorry for them. You know, absolutely. My friends came over this weekend from Minnesota and they are house hunting and they found this beautiful house that they went to go see and they got there and the house was garbage. It's like getting catfished on a house, right? So the idea is no matter how good the pictures are, right. at the end of the day when people get to go see you and see you for who you really are, they right. ain't buying the house if the presentation is exactly. not a representation of what I saw. So if you're at work or wherever you are and you're portraying yourself, I'm an attractive person, and you're saying people don't like me or I don't, you know, I have it hard and have it tough, then those people don't really get a chance to get to know you.
Exactly.
Because attractive or not, we all go through S-H-I-T. You know what I'm saying? We've all been through, we get cheated on, we get lied, you get stopped by the police.
I don't care how unattractive, whatever the measurement. I don't know who got the measurement stick of what's attractive and what's unattractive. I don't. So I don't know what's unattractive, what's considered unattractive versus what's attractive. It's but regardless, everyone gets cheated on, lied to.
Why go to work and not be beautiful?
I choose to just go to work and focus on my job and let my job shine through.
But you
can't be beautiful.
But you're in your fashion and your modeling, I mean, that's sweat.
That's who I am. But when I'm at work, I just go to work and just do my job. Now,
so
when it's time for me to do fashion
other
stuff,
people who can find you and mentor to and say, man, you're at work and I see the beautiful person you
so
are.
So this is the thing. So to what you're all exactly what you're saying, even when I am trying to just, you know what, I'm just going to chill today. I'm no makeup, whatever. Even when I'm doing that, this is the next point that I wanted to make. It don't stop shit. It don't stop my shine. It don't stop people gravitating towards me. And so I realized that even when I'm trying to just chill, not wear makeup, what's meant for me is for me. What's going to happen is going to happen. So I had to realize that I'm still going to shine through. My personality is still going to shine through. Those that are drawn to me are going to be drawn to me anyway. And those that are not drawn to me are those who want to just judge me and not get to know me, like you said. That's their loss. That's not my loss. Like this weekend when I was where I was, and for like maybe the first hour, I just felt just kind of uncomfortable. And I only was just kind of staying in my little seat talking to the, you know, my girls that was with me. And then after about, I don't know, 30, 40 minutes of that, I said in my head, fuck it. And I got up and I got to moving around and doing this and doing that and doing this and doing that. And that's when I noticed the other women stay sitting down and just kind of looking at me sideways. And, you know, I just saw different things and different things that were brought to my attention. And I was like, this is why I would never move back home. This is why I would never move back home, because in a smaller town, it's just, I don't know. It's like crabs in a barrel. It's horrible. But
it's only thank 13 you, production. Decent women in Alabama.
Don't do that. I told you about doing Alabama like that. But I say that to say that, you know, what you're saying that is right. If they don't take the time to get to know me or get to know whomever, that's their loss.
But how's
not
being,
the other person
how's
loss.
Being unattractive, being attractive, a negative thing?
It's not. It shouldn't be.
It's not, in my opinion.
In the study, they said attractive people are more likely to get fired, and people agree that they should have got fired. That's what it said. It also said that attractive people are more likely to be untrustworthy.
I heard that on the radio too. I heard that on the radio too.
Said I didn't want to date you because I feel like I can't trust you.
Like two, three exes.
Right. Well, yeah. But he didn't want to date you. He found you so attractive that he felt like other people would be attracted to you, and therefore
his exact words: "I can't make them. I cannot make them." And when he came, an idiot. So, and when he came back a year later and admitted to that and said all those things, he did say, "I am an idiot. I have insecurities that didn't have anything to do with you." And I realized a year later after our breakup that those were my insecurities. So basically, you broke my heart for nothing. But thank you for not being in my life, because
you dodged a bullet.
Because I dodged a bullet. I dodged a complete bullet. But yeah, that was his exact words.
I mean, that's like people who say, I'll go date
someone.
Like, I won't date a 10. I'll date like a 6 or a 7. Because
yeah, I call that marrying safe. And then when I do see good looking situations, I'm like, ooh, that person is marrying safe. It reminded me of, I'm sorry. Okay, so that's what me and some of my friends call it. We call it marrying safe.
So do you ever Cause
you know, people look and be like, oh, he must got a lot of money, or she must got, well, I just call it marrying safe.
So, but do you wonder why? You've had times where you wonder why, like how that happened? How did that relationship happen?
How did that happen? Everybody saw something sometimes and be like, how did that happen?
Right.
He and or she marrying safe.
It might not have to do nothing with marrying safe, and it might have a whole lot to do with, hey, this person is confident in their shit, and they don't care what other people feel about them in certain situations. Like there are things where
where this seven,
uh-huh, whoever it is, where I read some stuff to get ready for this show, this seven. Financially sound, has the stuff together, doesn't care what's going on. and treats her dude just fine. Where this 10 is relying on this 10, and they probably whack in bed, probably Ooh. Drop off that regular, Ooh. And probably only got
Shots fired.
That 10 just to hold on to.
Shots fired.
And that's the only thing that they bring into the table. Now, we've all seen that. Now, I don't have a problem saying it because I'm straight. But at the same time, I'm not talking about, I'm straight. But at the same time, I don't mind saying that I've dated beautiful women that was horrible with money, that had a whole bunch of kids, and that did not want to work.
I've heard that before.
So what are you bringing to the table besides your kids and them titties?
I've heard that before.
Your face.
And your face. What? Straight up.
It's the fact.
It's the same dude. Like, what
you
do you
can become unattractive. You can be attractive and become unattractive because all you have is your attractiveness. And that's
exactly. That can so be. Me, you can be attractive in the beginning. Once they get to know you,
there's
you,
plenty of
your
fine
characters
guys that
start
don't,
to make you unattractive. Right, so that happens every day to men and women.
People could look at you and look at your husband or look at your wife and say, oh, I don't see why they're together. And it's because, again, it's a very surface-level approach that you're looking at. If you think you can judge somebody in 10 seconds and decide why they should be together or not, or whether they are a good couple together because they look cute or they don't look cute, that's insanity.
Man. Who are you going to make you happy?
Absolutely.
It reminds me of basketball. Gerald's always talking about dudes who's so tall, right? And he calls it tall and that's all. So we'll go to a league game. He'll be like, oh, man, that guy's going to be good. He's like, man, that guy's tall and that's all. He ain't nothing but tall. And as they say when they're coaching, you can't teach tall. Like, the dude's tall, but he has no skills.
No game.
Trash.
None.
He's trash.
None.
But he's tall, so he can get, you know, a rebound.
Zero coordination. He just down there.
So you can look and judge someone and think, oh, man, that's a basketball player. Okay, no, that's a tall guy who can reach the basket. Doesn't
but cannot
make him a basketball
play the game.
Not a lick. And we see it. We see it all the time. You see it all the time. I wasn't out here trying to trash big-breasted chicks. I was just saying.
Who said something?
No. I was just, somebody in the chat room said them titties. That's all.
Hey,
what up, huh? My dad used to say, marry no more than 2 levels above your level and no more than 2 levels below your level.
Your dad said that? Pops. I like Pops. Pops is all right with me. Pops said, don't marry 2 above and 2 below.
No.
You got a 4-room spread?
Shout out to Curacao. What's up? They just, Francesca just tuned in from Curacao. We international in these streets. Listen, I just don't understand that. And there, like I said, I told you I was going to trash you in this situation.
But
so,
you look for opportunities to trash me, Jason, so.
You make it easy. But they're all right, so real quick, we've all seen at least one episode of Empire, right?
Yeah.
We all agree that Gabrielle Sibide, I don't know how you say it, but anyway, outside of Taraji Henson, she's probably the most famous person on there.
Taraji and
Terrence.
Okay, most famous woman.
Oh, woman. Okay, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Who would you say is the second most famous?
Well, Vivica Fox is on there.
She ain't got a lot of followers.
Tasha.
What? She ain't got a lot of followers.
Okay, then I give up.
All right, so the chick Soraya, do you know who that is?
The little skinny girl?
There's a bunch of them.
Oh, well then no.
Soraya Hakeem, baby mama.
That's what I was talking about when I said the little skinny one. Yeah.
She is right below Gabrielle Sidibe's, as far as Instagram followers. Why? Because she is an attractive person. Now, can you name anything that she's done outside of Empire? Can you name any? She's a musician, apparently, but.
I didn't know who she was. Do you know any of her songs?
No. But she's pretty. So we're going to get those followers up.
Sure.
We're going to get those opportunities up.
A lot of Instagram models with millions of followers.
Tons.
That don't deserve them.
Hey, don't do nothing.
Bernice Burgos go all over the world. And I don't know what else she does outside of being pretty, but she does that fine. Just fine.
Don't know who she is.
Well, okay.
Grandmodel.
Yeah, she does her Instagram thing to the fullest. And they pay her to be fine. And so, I don't know how many ugly people out here, how many... ugly people out here, news anchors, how many ugly people out here in movies? Like, you don't even see very many ugly people in movies.
It depends on Well,
what's funny to me is that somebody can be quote unquote average, and then all of a sudden when they get some fame, then all of a sudden they're attractive.
They're attractive.
I remember the guy in T'Challa in Wakanda. Like, he was just a regular guy, then all of a sudden, like, now he's Black Panther. Like, oh, he's fine. Fine 3 movies ago.
Like, you like M'Baku?
Oh, M'Baku now. Yeah, he was fine before Wakanda.
Wait, the dude who played the Black Panther lead role, he was attractive before?
I'm just saying.
Y'all weren't checking for him when he was Jackie Robinson.
When he played James Brown.
His Instagram followers was not the same.
Or Thurgood Marshall. Y'all didn't like this dude. Like, don't do that.
If you look at some of Jay-Z's old pictures, you'd be like...
You look at Jay-Z today, and you was like,
is
hold
that
on.
A four spread, Jay-Z to Beyonce?
Yeah, y'all wouldn't... Look, man, I had some videos I was going to get to. We can't get to it right now.
Oh,
and listen.
Good and after time.
Yeah, that is our time. Nett done raised her hand 2 or 3 times. Time I wrap it up. I appreciate everybody for tuning in. Y'all tuned in via Status Network app, Amazon Fire Stick, Roku, or however it is that you decided to watch, whether Facebook, Periscope, Instagram. We greatly appreciate it. We definitely appreciate it, and we will be back April 8th. That ain't no April Fool's. I ain't even hit y'all with no April Fool's joke.
I'm glad.
Should have.
We was going to tell you that Sway got married over the weekend.
We gonna tell you that Sway got that club shot up.
Don't April Fool's a pregnancy. That is the worst.
You get that club shot up?
I did not get that club shot up over the weekend.
April Fool's.
Still dry. Still dry balling around here. So, thank you for watching.
Do that.
Thank you for watching, everyone. Have a good night. I'm Sway Kenyatta.
Sway, you gotta fix it. Don't listen. End with that. You are not dry.
Still dry. Yeah, y'all taking it easy. We out.